Hello and servus from Bavaria. Welcome to our new mCast. In this channel, it's all about measurement, control and automation for moving webs. My name is Chris from Mahlo, and we've been dealing with straightening your fabrics for over 75 years. We therefore know exactly which problems arise here, but above all, we know what solutions there are. In today's video, we will show you all the important details of a weft straightener and how it helps you to get your fabric straight. Let's jump right in. Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is Chris and I'm working here at Mahlo at the application department. Today I want to talk about the weft straightening systems, and here I'm sitting at the original desk of our inventor of modern weft straightening systems, Dr. Heinz Mahlo. Earlier in the days he faced the problem of the distortion in the fabrics, but he solved it with the first mechanical weft straightener. The principle of the weft straightener never changed. The mechanical principle of bow and skew changing systems work until this day. Here at Mahlo, we made it to our task to develop and offer you, our customers, the best modern solution ever possible. Fun fact, earlier they used truck lights for the light source, but this changed, of course. So let's follow me to the new RVMC.
I lead you now into our exhibition hall, where we have our exhibition model and also our product of textile manager, Stephan. Hello.
Hello everybody. And if you look at that model, that has been created and designed normally for the real exhibitions, you know, in the good old days when we had to make our travel arrangements years ahead, and then we had to book those overpriced hotels and we had to squeeze ourselves into the exhibition halls. And therefore, this model contains all the benefits that you can have in the modern weft straightening history. But we also use that model for other purposes, don't we?
Yeah, that's right. We use it for the customer requirements to fulfill all the needs and to give you the best possible result for your interests. So let's take a look at some special ingredients and parts of the model.
Very good idea, Chris. Did you know that the principle of detection is still more or less the same as Dr. Mahlo invented it long time back? It still is with the transmitted light as the core principle of operation. And this still covers more than 90% of all the existing fabrics which are out there. Chris, how's your experience from the fabric samples that you get in for testing?
As you mentioned, mostly for 90% of the fabrics, we use our standard sensor. But of course, there are very difficult textiles in the world, very difficult fabrics, where we use some other kind of sensor techniques from Mahlo itself. So for example, the optoelectronic systems or the camera-based systems. Here at our exhibition model, we have the hybrid sensor. You can see it here. It combines the best system techniques from Mahlo itself.
And now that you have pointed it out, I see that the housing is also very special. We have made extensive tests and we finally came up that the anodized aluminium housing that we use in our sensor technique is really very, very good for the protection against corrosion. Chris, you have some experience how it looked like in the textile finishing, don't you?
It is all known that finishing lines in a textile fabric needs a lot of water content. So we have different kind of properties which exhausts the machine itself. For example, acid fumes or hot steam or dirty environment itself, and of course high moisture content in the air. All these environment conditions exhaust our mechanical parts.
Yeah, and I think this also counts for the movable parts over here. It goes without saying that if you want to have moving optics, if you are working with different working width, for example, and then of course you can have that. This is without any question. But there are not only advantages linked to that system. Chris, you have some experience in this field as well, don't you?
Mostly the fabric width is very constant, and the operator can check the sensor itself when they had the manual adjustment for the sensor heads. The operator itself can check, is the lens okay, is the system okay, does it work properly, for example.
So there is also an advantage for the manual adjustment.
This is great, because I think if the lens is not working properly, and then it really makes the difference between a proper production or a claim at the end. If this machine is blind, there's no way that it can give the right reading of the weft or the bow to the brain of the machine, and then all is for nothing. Now we've spoken about the sensors. Further down, there's another module, the tension control. Chris, from your experience, what do we need that tension control for?
So our weft straightener is used to straighten all kind of fabrics, from heavyweight fabrics to lightweight fabrics, from woven fabrics to knitted fabrics. But all fabrics have one in common. They need tension to be distorted. And our system introduces tension for the distortion process. So some fabrics do need some special treatment, like, for example, elastic fabrics or lycra-based fabrics, or, of course, silk fabrics or all other very special and high-quality-based fabrics. But without attention, the weft straightening process can't work. But is there only one kind of tension controller we use?
I'm very glad that you're asking, Chris. As a matter of fact, sometimes if we have to turn this machine upside down and we have to trick gravity, we don't only use this pendulum compensator, then we use a load cell in order to give the right information to the drives of the bow rollers in order to really eliminate that risk of tension to the fabric. Mm-hmm. And so we can also treat really the most sensitive fabric in a very, very gentle way. Okay, so now let's go to the heart of the weft straightener, the drives.
Hey, what's that?
It's blue light.
What does it do?
It turns blue. Here we are at the soul of our machines, the drives. Mahlo offers either the servo drives or the hydraulic drives. You can choose whatever is needed. In the construction, we normally have hydraulic drives when the going gets rough, like for cranes or caterpillars. Chris, when do you speak about very rough conditions in your testing?
Our weft straightener is able to straighten also heavyweight fabric like carpets, denim fabrics, or like terry towels. For this kind of fabrics, the machine needs a lot of force to straighten them. So in this case, we have a very compact hydraulic system here without pressure tank and also a leakage-safe system itself.
That's very good, because the hydraulic drives, they are normally linked to a lot of negative side effects like these leakages or the pressure reservoirs, which are not very good for the maintenance. So it is good to understand that Mahlo really have taken all the measures to eliminate all these negative side effects. So now that we have spoken about the soul, let's go and look into the brain of the machines.
Okay.
Well, now that we've talked about the heart and the soul of the machine, we finally arrived at the brain. And we are very proud to say that this machine is the smartest machine on the market. You know why, Chris?
A lot of fabric run through the finishing line machines where distortion is created. Small parts in the whole fabric length, and our machine is able to detect those part distortions and can reduce the fluctuation in it. And with that reducing, we can lower the effort and therefore also the tension the fabric needs for the distorting, for the straightening process.
Great. And we have done that with a special algorithm. This algorithm was created together with the German Institute, and it can predict the future. Not in the way that we know the lottery of tomorrow. However, we can anticipate the distortion, whether it builds up or whether it is going down. And by knowing what is happening in the future, we can actually reduce the momentum which is brought into the fabric. And that leads to a lot of good things.
Of course.
Do you know about some reactions from the market, Chris?
So therefore, we can reduce the maintenance. Also, like mentioned, lower the tension in the fabric. And of course, higher the lifetime of our mechanical parts. So this machine will run much longer than expected with this extra kind of software tool.
That's fantastic. And talking about software, I think one thing is the brain. The other thing is how to bring all the data onto the data highway and then into the world of the World Wide Web. Now let's have a look at the visualization and of course the data highway of Mahlo. Now that we've talked about the heart, the soul, and the brain of the machine, I finally want to cover one topic which is very hot these days. It's the data highway. It's Internet of Things, it's Industry 4.0. And this machine is equipped with all the necessary interfaces that you can participate in this data highway. You can share your data with whoever you want. You can share it with your customers, with your subsidiaries. You can share it with any other division. And you can make sure that the data, the transparency that you create is really there where it's needed most. But once you have shared it, you can actually also create it in a different way. The basis is the display over here. And this display is very user-friendly. How does it come?
So during the years, many operators from our customers became friends or even family members. So they work every day with our system. So we asked them during the development process, what can we improve? How can we do it user-friendly and intuitive? So we had the pleasure to work very closely with the operators, which were very helpful. So we could create a new surface, which is also mentioned, user-friendly, intuitive, and they love to work every day with them because it's just what they want to do.
And I know from my own experience in the production that whatever you do with a passion, whatever you do with a lot of tender love and care, you do in a very professional way. And this is just one of the many secrets which are behind the quality and the success of this machine, and the others we've told you earlier on. And so if you have any additional question, just go into the chat or drop us a line in an email. From my side and from yours as well, I think for today it's bye-bye and thank you very
Goodbye.
Much for your attention.
Thank you very much for watching. Did you like the video? Then feel free to give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, then you won't miss any new mCast videos. We would love to hear your comments and suggestions, so if you like, put them in the comments section. I look forward to see you in the next mCast. My name is Chris from Mahlo and Servus from Bavaria.